I'm Chris, one of the scientists at Accelerate. Today I'm going to be showing you how we perform our tests for regulatory skin sensitization. These tests assess the potential for a chemical or cosmetic to be a sensitizer to human skin. We provide three tests and use them in combination, with each test holding a key event in the skin sensitization pathway. The DPRA assesses protein binding, the keratinocens, keratinocyte activation, and the HCLAT, dendritic cell activation. It's recommended to follow a 203 approach, whereby you perform two of the tests, look for concordant results, and only proceed to the third test when the results don't match. After receiving a product into the lab, we test its solubility to determine the concentration we can test it at. This process varies depending on the test it's going into, as different tests use different solvents. The sample goes on to be tested in the lab. It's important to keep in mind that the majority of in vitro tests performed around the world still use animal-derived components, such as fetal bovine serum, posing issues for both ethics and the scientific relevance to humans. At Accelerate, we've adapted the methods to animal product-free conditions. For the DPRA test, the sample is prepared in solution and combined with peptides. Then the peptide binding is read using high-performance liquid chromatography. The amount of peptide binding measured translates into a positive or negative result. For the keratinocens test, the test item is diluted over a range of concentrations, and this is applied to keratinocens cells. The cells are incubated with the test item for 48 hours before we detect a luminescent signal using the spectrophotometer. This signal can be used to measure the potential of sensitization. In the HCLAT, THP1 cells are incubated for 24 hours with the test item, and using flow cytometry, we measured the expression of cell surface markers. These markers are expressed following skin sensitization. Data is analysed and the product is classified as either positive or negative for each test. And the combination of these results determines whether the product is classified as a sensitizer. Remember, if these results don't match, we'll move on and do a third test. A report's written for the client, which includes the details and results of the study. And thanks to our GLP accreditation, these results can be submitted to regulatory bodies. A huge amount of progress has been made in the field of in vitro testing in the past decade, with many methods now becoming the default choice for safety assessors. These technologies have advanced both our ability to protect human health, as well as being both ethical and sustainable.